this section of my video, we'll be going through another topic, which is important one, that is the factors affecting the resistance of a conductor. So in this concept, in this topic, we'll be go through the concepts, the logic, how the resistance of any conductor can be varied. As you have observed or you can see in my last section, we have gone through the concept of Ohm's law. Under the Ohm's law, you have studied or observed that resistance is a constant. I'll again write the concept of Ohm's law, which we have gone through, that potential difference was directly proportional to current. Converting the proportionality to equality, we have taken a constant R, where R is the resistance of conductor. So we had observed that V by I was equals to R, that is actually a constant. But going through practical senses, going through practical observations, we had observed that on varying certain parameters, if we go through the concept or go through the readings of the resistance, we had observed that different value of current has been measured by the instrument. Because as you can see in this expression, that resistance is also dependent on current. If we assume that resistance is not a constant, if the resistance of conductor is varied, then the current will also be varied. So we will go through this concept, that how it happens, what are the factors which are affecting or varying the resistance of a conductor. Let us understand what resistance is. Resistance is actually the opposition which is created by the conductor. I have written a definition. Let's go through the definition. The resistance of a conductor is simply the opposition or obstruction posed by the conductor to the flow of electric current in any circuit. This is known as resistance. Now, resistance is important because it maintains the flow of current in any circuit. I am again repeating, the resistance offered by a conductor is an important quantity because it maintains the flow of current in any circuit. That is represented by capital R. Also, the symbol of resistance is R. The unit of resistance is Ohm, and here I had made the symbol of resistance. Now, we will move on towards the factors which are contributing towards the changing of resistance. The very first point, which shows that resistance is directly proportional. I'll mention here, resistance is directly proportional to the length of any conductor. Now, directly proportional means on increasing the length of the conductor, the resistance increasing, while on decrement of the length or decreasing the length of conductor, the resistance of the conductor also decreases. So this is the first factor on which the resistance of conductor depends. Moving on to the second factor, which says resistance is inversely proportional to the area of cross section of conductor, which means that inversely proportional implies that on increasing the area, resistance decreases, while on decreasing the area, resistance increases. So this implies that on varying the cross section of the particular conductor, the resistance of conductor can also be varied, but in inverse manner, that is opposite to depth of length. There is another parameter. Resistance is directly proportional to resistivity. I have written that is the material of the conductor. Since you use different materials for making resistances, there are different materials which are required, which are used for making resistance. Each material offers a different resistance. So each material is offering a different resistance. There will be a different value of net resistance contributing. So we should take care or make a better choice while making a resistance with the help of the resistivity of different materials. Combining the all three parameters, I'll write R equals to rho L by A. So I'll get an expression for resistance also, which is expressed in terms of R equals to rho L by A. Now, with the whole thing related to the variation of resistance, it should be kept in mind that if it is being asked or it is being expressed in any question, that if the resistivity of any particular material is varied, what will be the effect on the resistance. So you should know that if you are varying the resistivity of a particular conductor, then the resistance remains constant. The reason is the resistivity actually depends on the material of conductor. So you should make it a point that if it be asked that you are varying the resistivity of any conductor, will the resistance be same? Yes, the resistance will remain the same because resistivity is dependent on material of conductor. Now, if you want to change the resistance with the help of this parameter, what you have to do that you have to change the particular material. Let us suppose you are using material A. I have already explained you that there are different materials required for making resistances. If you had made a resistance with the help of material A, in order to change the resistance, you have to change the material. That is, take another material, make a resistance of that. In this manner, the resistance can be changed. The factor which is not being discussed here is temperature. So temperature is another factor which is important parameter in changing the resistance of any conductor. While doing a practical or while doing a practical section, you will observe that if the temperature of a particular material is being changed, the resistance also varies. So remember this point that apart from the points you have studied here, that is the length, area and resistivity, the another parameter is temperature, which is also changing the resistance of temperature. So this was the whole concept of resistance. So you have just gone through the definition, unit, the parameters onto which resistance of a conductor depends. I hope you have gone through this well. Thank you so much.